So how does the car design support the performance of the car?
The design of the car supports the performance of the car through being a piece of technical sculpture. And what I mean by that is the surfaces are designed in a way to guide the air around and through the body for optimal cooling and downforce. So essentially, the car and the surfaces you see are all performing a job. And as you analyse it and you imagine you're the air flowing around the car, you will understand why the shapes and the surfaces are the way they are.
Rob, can you elaborate on your design philosophy for everything for a reason?
Well, we use it to guide all of our decisions regards all the attributes, whether they're visual, technical, so the performance attributes, the ergonomic attributes. And of course, as a team, we always ask why. So through asking those questions, is the new idea, is it fresh? Is it relevant? Does it make the product better? Because ultimately, we need to deliver the most engaging end product we can to the customer.
What do you mean when you say that the Artura's interior is driver-focused?
Okay, when we say the interior of the Artura is driver-focused, that means the architecture, the position of the controls, the instrumentation, the overall geometry of the cabin is focused towards the driver. Because essentially at McLaren, we put the driver at the centre of the action. So you have that broad, deep windscreen, fantastic for the for visibility, whether you're in town or on the track. The next thing then is the actual layout themselves, the controls. So the instrumentation, the centre console is directed, aimed towards the driver. So all the controls are very much to hand. And what's more, we've taken that concept to an all-new level with the binnacle. So now on the binnacle, the instrumentation pack, we have the dynamic control, so you can literally engage in the moment, enjoy the experience, and really just feel how nimble and agile the Artura is, and go through the dynamic controls whilst keeping your hands on the steering wheel and your eyes on the road. We also use incredible materials, lightweight, premium, luxury materials that really have this very advanced, high-tech look and feel to them. This combined with what I would call an incredible piece of ambient lighting design make the interior of Artura very focused, very simple, pure, but beautifully crafted.
You've announced this car is all new. Is it really all new?
The Artura is made of approximately 4,000 individual parts or assemblies, and virtually every single one of them has been re-engineered from scratch, specifically for the Artura. There is no carryover content from any of our previous models, whether it's the carbon fiber lightweight architecture, the high-performance hybrid powertrain, or else the entire body exterior, interior, and even the electrical architecture is all new. I have worked at McLaren for the last 15 years, and by far, the Artura is the largest, more intensive innovation and engineering undertake that I can remember. We're very proud of it, and we can't wait to deliver cars to our customers now.
I was wondering what is so special about the high-performance hybrid powertrain.
Many different things. In particular, what gets me personally is this unique combination of supercar class-leading performance achievements and the level of efficiency that we've achieved with this powertrain, but also some of the clever technologies that have been developed and implemented to achieve this set of attributes. 680 PS and 720 Newton meters. The electric motor delivers 225 Newton meters of instant torque, which makes the Artura the best ever McLaren in terms of throttle response. Some of the technologies are super clever. When you look at the fact that the V6 is linerless, or the 3D printing technology that is used to manufacture the intricate cavities for oil and cooling fluids inside the engine, all of this makes the Artura's engine one of the shortest and lightest. And it's in fact 50 kilos lighter than our current V8. But also the efficiency figures, 129 grams of CO2 per kilometer, and last but not least, the possibility to drive the car in pure electric mode with the 7.4 kilowatt hour battery sustaining up to 30 kilometers of EV range.
Obviously, McLaren is very well known for its innovation and technology in those materials and its use of them in their road cars. And I was just wondering how they've managed to get it to the next level with the Artura.
Much like when we launched the 12C with the monocell, McLaren has used carbon fiber technology to take the game even further. McLaren carbon fiber lightweight architecture is even lighter, it's safer, and more importantly, is stronger. When we've got to accommodate hybrid performance engines in our hybrid cars, we want to make sure that we're using as less weight as possible. And this is achievable with our MCLA structure. We've developed these systems in the McLaren Composite Technology Center. And we're really using our technology advancements at that composite center to our advantage to save weight and reduce the car's overall mass, giving us a combined weight of 1,498 kilograms.
As we are on the topic with the new McLaren Artura, our question will be, having a battery, can you still take it on the track?
So even with the battery pack, the Artura and its full dynamic and performance capabilities can be enjoyed equally on the road and on track. There is an electric motor, axial flux, that sits in between the engine and the gearbox with upstream and downstream disconnect clutches, so we can change the configuration of the system such that the car can provide the full power and torque output on the road and on track from both the internal combustion engine and the electric system. The car, of course, can also be driven in electric-only mode when the electric motor is disconnected from the engine and it drives the wheels through the rear transmission.
Hey Ella, congrats on the car, looks fantastic. Particularly enjoy the way that the rear looks. Am I right in thinking that that is one single panel? And if so, how do you go about achieving that?
So we've got a whole mixed media on the car in terms of body panels. We've got our aluminium bonnet. We've got composite panels with the front and rear bumper and the front splitter. But what's really interesting is the superformed aluminium alloys. So we have these on the doors, the roof, and most importantly, that beautiful rear clam body panel. The beauty of having superformed panels that means that it allows us to have undisturbed design, but also it means we can use less panels on the car, which of course reduces the weight even further.
And I'm asking what the McLaren Artura will be like to drive compared to the other McLarens.
Well, the first thing to say is that despite all the new technology in Artura, there's some aspects that will feel instantly recognisable to those that are familiar with our current range of cars. And that was a deliberate decision, because we believe the way a McLaren goes down the road, the way it steers, the fundamental agility in the car, well, it's unique, and we wanted to maintain that feel. What will feel new, or at least to anyone who's not had the opportunity to drive either the P1 or the Speedtail, is the torque delivery, the power delivery, because the high-performance hybrid powertrain gives you fantastic throttle response. And at McLaren, we believe, just like great steering feel can fantastically transform a driving experience, so can throttle response.
The question for you guys is, what makes McLaren's handling so special?
Well, it starts with our mid-engine layout, which places the weight of the car really right at the center for the best fundamental agility. And then, of course, we've got our carbon fiber construction that not only makes the car very light, but it also provides a great structural stability, meaning that we've got super accurate suspension movements. Then we tune the suspension hardware to give you this great combination of both stability and also agility, which means that for you, the driver, you've got options of how you want to drive the car. And in Artura, our new e-differential really helps in this regard. But at McLaren, we believe just as important as the fundamental agility that you have in the car, it's the confidence and connection that you get with the car through the control surfaces, which is why we put so much effort into tuning our hydraulic steering system to give you the best possible steering feel. And just one more point, and it's probably the most fundamental, important point overall, which is the weight of the car. All McLarens are super light, and we've put a real focus into the new Artura to make sure it's the lightest car in its class.